Good evening, everybody. Today we are inpatient for some testing. My daughter Gracelyn has been having seizures since she was a year old, and we don't talk a lot about our medical stuff on here, so I thought I would kind of start talking about the adventures that we have through our medical. Well, today is a little bit complicated. We came to the hospital at, I guess it was 9:30, and they got us into our room right away, and we're about to do shift change, so it's going to be a little chaotic here in a minute, so I wanted to get this done. This afternoon, Grace had a cluster of myoclonic seizures that resulted in giving her some rescue meds. And we're trying to find the other new seizures that she's been having on monitor. I'll let you kind of, I'm gonna turn you around real quick so you guys can see. This is her room, but there she is. Can you wave to everybody? Yeah. And so she's has little electrodes all over her head, and they're being monitored to a machine. They video every action and everything that we do, which I think is kind of crazy, but it helps them when she has one to kind of see it on camera. What happened? Okay, I'll help you in just a second. Stay still. And so, anyway, this is probably gonna be really short, but I've taken some pictures. I thought I'd gather together day one of our day in the EMU and hopefully help a lot of you understand why, as a family, we've determined that life is too short to sit in a brick and mortar home anymore and just let life pass us by. So I hope everybody has a blessed day, and I'm gonna add some video and some photos to the end of this. So feel free to share it, because this is what epilepsy and schizencephaly has done for our life. It's created a new dimension that has been very restricting, where we have learned that a brick and mortar home is even more restricting. So that's why we have taken on the greatest adventure I feel that we have taken on in our whole entire life. And we can't wait to take on even more adventures. So I'm trying to stay positive today. It's getting a little wearing. It's only going on 6 o'clock, and I feel like I'm already in a cracker box. We have two more days of these, and hopefully we'll capture what we need before we get a chance to go home. If not, the doctors don't think I'm crazy, which is the good thing. So hopefully everybody's having a blessed day, and we will talk with you later. Bye.
Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. You got it. You're doing so good. Keep blowing. Keep blowing. Keep blowing. Keep blowing. Keep blowing. You got it, baby. You got it.
There was a farmer had a dog. And bingo. I know what we could sing. Hot cross buns.
No!
Hot cross buns.
No!
See how they run.
No!
They all run after the farmer's wife.
No!
The top and you feel real funny, your tummy kind of tickles.
Have you ever been on a roller coaster?
Yes.
You have?
No.
No, no.
How about a fast elevator? You ever been on a fast elevator and it kind of makes your stomach kind of funny? Mm-hmm. Well, that's what this was like. We kept going down and we get to the bottom, get outside, and it's really spongy. Like, have you ever been on a big trampoline? I'm making the story short, just so you know. I'm on this, it's like this trampoline. It's real bouncy. Have you ever been on a trampoline?
I've been on a trampoline.
You have been on a trampoline.
Isn't it fun? And you bounce up and down? Well, that's what we were doing.
I've been on a trampoline at...
Hey guys, so you got the rundown on where we're at, and then I also just posted some pictures in front of this, so I wanted to let you know that Grayson is peacefully sleeping, and hopefully we'll have an uneventful night. If not, I guess I will be not sleeping much myself, but I wanted to... make sure that you guys all subscribe and like this. This is about awareness for rare disabilities and also the trials that we go through as a family. We face a lot. This year is January already, 2020, and we have started our year off with some in-hospital testing. And then last year we finished our year off crazy, but we definitely want to make sure you guys are aware of what's going on, our struggles, our just everyday hurdles that go through everything. It is not abnormal for us to have to use rescue meds for Graceland on a daily basis. So just make sure that you guys like it and you subscribe it, and then you ring your bell so that you get your notifications before anyone else. And then we are glad that you guys have been praying for us, and we're thankful for everything. Keep up the prayers, as we know that you're with us, and that it's important that we bring awareness to everything that we do. So this year is going to be a lot more of like our nitty gritty, good, bad, and the ugly. So right now I do not look amazing because my hair is like, I don't know. I don't even know what to think about this hair. But we've had an awesome nursing staff today, and tonight they're training some people, so we've gotten to kind of go over some just logistics. But I wanted to give updates, so I'm sure the nurses will come in and check on her in a little bit. But in the meantime, I'm going to relax and enjoy some quiet time while she's asleep. So I will update everybody again tomorrow.